Hi guys, another video for you people. Well, today this one is about commitment. So I wanted to ask you guys, how far would you go to commit to someone by doing something you don't want to, but you still want to show that, hey, I'm kind of loyal to you. I've seen a lot of men get themselves in specific situations that can be quite interesting. I'm not saying that a woman can, yes, of course. It happens on both sides, but usually it's like, if you do this, you love me. And usually those commentary are more, it usually comes from the lady. So let me know. Let's watch this video because I think it will actually explain exactly what I'm trying to say.
Oh my God. Where are you? Oh, wow. What are you doing here?
What are you doing here? What is that?
This.
We're vegan.
I'm done with this.
This is an animal.
Yes.
No.
We've been vegan for 4 years.
No. Okay. Why would somebody think that you could do that to my food? I mean, that's like, why would you be able to pick something up and throw it on the floor that is mine? It doesn't compute. Look at how he's looking at the burger. It's like, oh, that's a good burger. No, not anymore.
Are you serious,
though? This isn't even vegan.
I should took a whiff from that. You're like, oh, it's delicious.
This is an animal. I don't care anymore. I'm done with it. I'm done with you controlling my life. I'm done with being vegan.
This was a joint decision.
Oh, whoa. I am done with you controlling my life. Is it a joint decision? No. Whatever he said there means it wasn't a joint decision. If somebody responds like that, oof. You don't say it's a joint decision, right? I mean, I've said something to get some poom poom or make sure I will get some poom poom, but you have to be ninja about it. I mean, joint decision, or usually you say that, you know what, I will just say, so she kind of stop talking about the issue or stop pressuring the issue. That I kind of get, but something that you have to hide forever? For a very long time and you have to go in secret? Ah man, I don't think that's gonna work for you in the long run, but let's see.
At the time, I was just trying to impress you.
Ooh, yep, told you. I was trying to impress you. Simple.
I've been doing this behind your back for weeks now.
Oh, shit.
I go to Macca's. I'm with my friends and I eat
meat. I'm with my friends. Of course, eating Macca's.
Are you kidding me?
Serious.
We committed to this.
What are you doing here?
I was filling up my car.
You just so happened to be here. You checked my
Yes,
Snapchat.
I was filling up my car.
You stalked me on Maps again.
No, but I clearly should have.
Whoa.
Yes, I was filling up my car.
You stalked me on Maps again.
Whoa. Stalking on Maps again? Okay, no. That's already creepy. I would shit my pants if that happened to me. If suddenly I'm just hanging around and I'm like, oh shit, she might be stalking me and she's gonna find me on Maps, I need to turn it off, or he already turned it off and she miraculously still found him. Damn, that's not an accident. Oof, that's crazy, man. That is not marriage material. I am sorry if you need to track me down because you don't trust me. I mean, you do you. You might have done something to deserve the attention, but I would never want to be in a situation that a woman has to track me down. Ever. Are you freaking kidding me? I don't have time for that. Your issues, handle them. Don't include me. Oh, man. I feel bad for this dude.
I can't believe you're here. Where did you go? This was an animal.
Yeah, it was an animal. They're going to sell it to someone else. Why not?
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's what most people would say. Yeah, they're gonna do it anyway. The problem is with vegans that I realize is they watch specific videos that even I can't handle, you know? For example, I would never be able to kill an animal comfortable, but I'm surely will be used to do it if I have to do it. But specific people can. But vegans can even imagine that idea in my experience, and that's why they watch so much more video of these so horrible killings. That's quite disgusting for by my view. I can't watch it. I've seen some things, especially on Facebook, and they delete them very quickly, but it's more for the shock. One vegan did that one time to me, the one that you have all these chickens, and she's like, they're all cute, beep, 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 but they're actually on a saw machine or something weird like that, and the thing just bursts and eats all the little baby chickens, and it's so disgusting. And when I did like, what are you doing? And she was laughing because she's like, that's the way I get off, just like I do my mama jokes, which is kind of horrible, but we're not gonna get into that.
We decided to make this world a better place by not consuming animals.
Now I've decided that I want to go back to it. I feel like crap. I feel malnourished. I can't even get up of bed at the morning.
That's because you're eating the wrong types of food. You know?
But when I went vegan, I have to admit, it wasn't hard in the beginning, but in the later ages, it did feel kind of exhausting because I had to eat more of different stuff. And I did feel less energized, I have to admit. Not in a bad way, but yeah, your body needs to get used to it. But if you're quite young, I don't know, maybe you need more energy and so you need more to refill it. In my experience, it wasn't that big a deal. It was kind of chill. I just was like, you know what? I could not make enough bland. The food was too bland for me. So I didn't really enjoy it in the long run. And I just thought I would feel more, better, fitter, which was true, less heavy stomach. But I had to spend more time preparing the food. And I hate spending time to prepare any food. I consider it time consuming.
You're not getting enough protein. You can have chickpea.
It's not satisfying me as much as McDonald's.
Wait, what the heck is chickpea? I have no idea what is chickpea. Google, what is chickpea? Oh, garbanzos. I mean, that ain't bad, but if you're gonna compare it to McDonald's, yeah, it's gonna lose, especially for some certain young people. I mean, woo, my wife makes this every day. I'm always having chickpea. I wish it was McDonald's. But you know me, I gotta lose that weight, get the original body.
No.
That is not the right answer. You're forcing your idea on other people because that's the better option. Oh my god. That's like me trying to do anal and yeah, you're forcing your idea on it. That's the better option. I mean, well, yeah, you save condoms. But the point is, oh my god, this is... Okay, don't be in a relationship. It's quite clear they're not together and he's just doing this for the poom poom and that's it. I mean...
Sorry, what's happening? Oh, there's something
wrong. We're vegan.
We start to be vegan.
Okay, can we not make a mess though? I'll sort this out.
She's telling the lady veganism is more important than your job to keep the place clean. She got the priority string. It's the better option.
Well, this is my restaurant and you're making a mess and I don't really appreciate it. So you can either go and take your food outside and continue.
What do you have to talk about?
We need to talk outside.
That's
alright. That's okay, so let me clean it up. I'll sort that out. I'll try sorting that. We need to have a
So let me know what you guys think about this. In general, I can say some people have very strong opinions on specific stuff. And I think that's a very hard thing to do. But especially in these ages, about dating is already horrible enough. We have so many options. So people are less likely to commit. So they just lie to pretend they're committing. Because there's so much baggage and there's so much option out there. Would you lie to get the love that you need? Or would you stay solo and just get a little but not exactly what you want? What do you think is the best option in the long run? Is it something that has to be clarified in the beginning, or it's something that you just go into the relationship, lie about it, and hope you guys stick together? For me, I'm a guy that, you know what, I put everything on the table in the beginning, because a lot of people are like, it's not important to say those stuff, while others believe you have to do it immediately. I'm like this. Whenever I date anybody, I always think in the long term. I don't think about just tomorrow. That's the way I think. I like to invest in people. I don't discard people. I don't discard friendship. I don't discard clothes. So it's just the way I like to think. For me, it's the better option. So if I put everything on table and the other person knows where I'm coming from, I think it's a lot more healthy for both of us. That's the way I think. If you have people that are like, I don't have to tell you everything from the beginning. No, you don't have to do it. But you can be surprised that when you release that information later, they might lie because they're like, I really like you, but I don't want to lose you because you have a different way of doing stuff. Because you were comfortable because you're seeing it later. I'm not. So let me know what you guys think, because I think it's actually a quite interesting point for some discussion.
Don't get me wrong, my cosa quita bon. Put a fire na mi blonde, kush hash purple skunk, criollo colombici jam jam, turlo keta verdeta welcome.